he's also really good at boxing. Tilts are super good. Literally, up tilt's super good. I don't think Ness can.
Probably not. Or like down tilt on shield. Ness doesn't have a good, like, directly in front of him out of shield option. It's not like super close there.
You don't like Anthony Fantano?
Probably will be aiming to not be in shield very much, if possible.
Yeah.
One thing with Ness is that he doesn't have the same like walling capability that a sword character does, or a zoner like Rob does against Kirby. So he might be forced to interact with him a bit more.
I'm expecting a lot of raw grabs here in this matchup. Literally, you know, 6 feet. And whoever's in the air, it's gonna be they're gonna have a hard time too. Just trying to hit with an air right now. Because if they most likely with the grabs, both of these characters want to grab.
Especially Ness. Just because, well, I mean, both characters have like kind of a poor disadvantage state.
Yeah.
Because of kind of poor airspeed, kind of floaty.
I'm sure they are looking for the same thing pretty much when they're both in the air.
Mm-hmm.
Just try to get a landing. They're both floaty.
Yeah. Eventually, try to push them off stage.
Yeah.
That will be one of the biggest goals from both players, because I think we'll see a lot of stocks taken off stage.
Yeah. This is like a classic matchup, like way back when Smash Bros. Kirby.
Of course. Someone was talking about Gnn0gg yesterday. It was like, someone remembers.
Yeah. So what I see from back then, when Ness recovers, Kirby's typically just down.
Makes sense. If you can get the positioning. One thing that might make it hard is if Ness upbees from a little further away from the stage instead of directly under.
Yeah, just makes it uncomfortable for Kirby. Mm-hmm.
Does PK Thunder 2 interacting with Kirby downbeat, does that shorten it in the same way that like running into
It does if
Hurt Box does?
Yeah, but then I feel like you're most likely just bound to get hit if you're as Ness.
Fair.
Because it's going down. There's no way you're going to hit the top or the side of it. If it's going down, it's always an active Ness for the
first
So I kind of expect a lot of PK fires.
Probably. Gnog is a pretty big fan of that move. Oh, okay, maybe.
We've been discussing
the wrong matchup like 3 minutes.
That is totally fine. I mean, they were hanging out at the corner for a minute. I'm not sure what they were discussing.
No. But both players are kind of specialists to their characters, so it'll be interesting to see their characters from them. I don't think I've ever seen Camden use that earlier than Kirby.
Yeah, same here. Okay, so typically here, I know Wolf wants to burst in. Marth just wants to wall him out with his sword. Mm-hmm. I never see Gnog play Marth before.
Me neither. I know he plays Sephiroth. Probably trying to work on his spacing a bit. But once Wolf is in this matchup, it's a really good combo weight and floatiness for Wolf. Like, pretty much every conversion off of fair works on Marth.
And right there, it's really hard for Marth to land against Wolf, too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, sure, you have a disrupt just to claw him out, but like, landing with it, it's not great. Wolf could just shield, punish you.
Yeah, he doesn't really have a great hitbox directly under
him. How fast is that stock? That was like a 0 to death, right?
In that state.
That
trap by Marth.
Yeah, especially as Wolf, where you rely a lot on aggressive options off ledge, Marth's range makes it a lot harder to force your way in with ledge hop fair and air.
F tilt, sweet spot too.
Yeah, I would guess we'll see a lot of jump off ledge and neutral get up shield from Wolf. Generally your safest options against characters with disjoints at the ledge.
Both of these characters are really good at ledge trapping. Wolf typically has a lot of options to kill.
You have throws, forward tilts, nairs, like you said.
I think right here, Camden's having a hard time trying to steal this stock.
I think so. A lot of...
Ooh, that's actually so good.
This should be a stock for Gnog here. Yeah.
I can't believe he actually got that.
Yeah, one thing we see from Wolf players who don't main Wolf a lot is they'll struggle to kill in the way that, like, melee Marth does, where either you kill at, like, 100 with, like, a tech chase down smash, yeah, or you kill with, like, back throw at 160.
You need something new here. I kind of want to see up tilt.
Yeah. I mean, he's looking for these dash attacks, but it's getting kind of stale.
It is.
And I don't think he's getting the hitbox he wants, the one that sends up.
That was actually the first up smash.
Yeah. I'll be interested to see if we see more of those, as Gnn0gg just doesn't always tipper his aerials.
And
I know that Marth is still fairly safe if you don't tipper, but it kind of depends on the option he chooses after hitting the shield.
Yeah, and it's the spacing too.
Mm-hmm.
I think Wolf typically wants to whiff punish Marth.
Yeah.
Just dash grabs.
Dash attack is really good in this matchup.
Yeah. And Wolf's dash grabs are pretty good too.
Yeah, it's great. And his burst range is just surprisingly long,
mm-hmm,
even though he's not as fast as the, like, Fox. He can just cover a lot of space with his initial dash.
Yeah, like, he does look pretty slow, but, like, once he's grounded, his ground game's strong.
It's very strong.
Like, in the air, it's, sure, he's not that good.
What?
Like, in the air, like, the only good option is just in the air. I'm saying, like, as in the air.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. Because one of the other things that extends his burst range is his airspeed being so good. Ooh, SDs from Gnn0gg.
Set up one, yeah, can I get Fake Mango and Scotty too?
If he wants to land in the air.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if he sneaks in a back air off here, that's on. That's your problem. You got hit.
Yeah, the shield safety of Wolf's moves is not super great, so he relies on spacing them really well.
Ooh. Literally tipper back air. Mid stage 2 from 4-set.
Maybe not the greatest DI, but Marth's aerials are still very strong in this game, even though it's a bit harder to hit tippers.
I
wonder what we'll see as a counter pick from Camden. Small battlefield. I know he's a fan of this stage with Kirby. Maybe a comfort pick.
Kirby.
Okay.
Does Gnn0gg stay Marth here? Pretty sure he does.
We'll see. Probably trying to practice a new character.
Possibly. Or maybe he doesn't like Kirby.
Maybe.
But yeah, Camden's switching to Kirby. Character he's most comfortable
pretty
with.
Much what we'd expect.
Yeah.
See him, I think he took 5th yesterday at Mech with Kirby.
Yeah. Oh,
that's a great result for him.
Yeah. I think he took
4th?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then, okay, so this matchup here.
Snake,
pretty much both characters are waiting to play land, just wall out. Kirby usually doesn't want to approach.
Yeah, as much as possible you want them to approach you. The problem Kirby has is that he doesn't really have a good tool to force approaches.
Mm-hmm.
He has no resource to accumulate or anything.
Yeah, Kirby's ground game is super strong. I think probably stronger than Marth's.
In general, yeah. I think probably the hardest tool for him to deal with is down tilt on shield, just because it's so safe.
Nice parry. I'm surprised that kill. He was at 100.
Yeah, maybe, again, some questionable DI.
I like that he's doing forward air grab, but then it doesn't match his position.
Yeah, and Marth's floatiness can kind of pop him up a bit too sometimes.
Good tilts.
And this is Kirby's bread and butter in the matchup, really. As soon as he gets in your face, he can really bully you.
Just thinking of B option there. Probably trying to call out a jump or something.
Possibly.
Force an option.
Just covers a lot of space.
I like that camera. That
was, yeah. He knew that Marth would probably try to force his way back with something aggressive.
Down smash here, probably trying to cover your launch style.
Probably. Either that or rush dude will get out. Gnn0gg has been picking really quick options off ledge. Instead of taking his time.
don't like that down here. I mean, I get it, but now you're in a disadvantaged state.
Set up three. Can I get Minky guy 700 and Yoshi?
He makes it better. I do kind of want to see him attempt it, going off stage, contested his recovery.
It's just hard with how quick Marth's recovery is, and I believe it has some intangibility frames at the startup, right?
Yes, it does. Surprise, he died.
Alright, set up five. Can I get Sean BGM and Dami Mami 12?
Daggers. That was well spaced. I'm surprised he got caught there.
It's possible that Kirby's legs were still extended enough to just get hit by the grab.
Scary.
Ooh,
life.
The flub from Gnn0gg. He could have taken the game right there. We'll see if he can maintain the same pace in neutral. It's been working really well for him. He's doing a great job of staying grounded in a way that Kirby can't get in. We're seeing a lot of forward tilt. Forward tilt's nice too because it covers Kirby's short hop.
Yeah.
One of his best approach options is just dash in, short hop fair, and forward tilt stuffs that out completely.
I think F tilt in general is just a very strong tool. It's technically safe, like even other tools.
It also has a pretty generous tipper hitbox now after the buffs.
Nice back here.
Now we see a little more patience from Gnn0gg at the ledge. Aware that Camden is scouting out faster up. Wow.
Yeah, right, dude? Are you okay?
A very, very emotional reaction from Gnn0gg. I think this is his best win in Ultimate.